Hello. Today we are going to discuss how to find the surface area of a frustum of a cone by considering a KCSE question, which reads, a cone of radius 20 centimeters has a slant height of 52 centimeters, and the frustum is cut off from this cone such that its top is 10 centimeters and the slant height is 26 centimeters. You've been asked to calculate the area of the curved surface of a frustum. So to find the area of the curved surface of this frustum here, you find the area of the curved surface of the cone, which is given as pi r l. That is the larger cone, the curved surface area. You subtract the curved surface area of the smaller cone, which is given as pi r l. So substituting these values here, we'll have 22 over 7 times. This is the radius of the larger cone, which is 20. You multiply by the slant height of the larger cone, which is 52. We subtract the smaller cone, which is 22 over 7, multiplied by the radius of the smaller cone, which is 10, multiplied by the slant height of the smaller cone. So the slant height of the smaller cone is the slant height of the larger cone, which is 52, minus the height, slant height of the frustum, which is 26. So 52 minus 26 is 26. Substituting this, you'll have 3, 2, 6, 8, 4 over 7. You subtract, keying in this in your calculator, you have 8, 17, 1 over 7. Subtracting, you'll have 2, 4, 5, 1, 3, 3 over 7 centimeters squared. Alternatively, we can use this formula to find the curved surface area of the frustum. That is pi L brackets R plus R, where L is the slant height. So when you're using this formula, you just need to consider the frustum only. So in this case, let us have this frustum here, where you're given the radius of the upper circle as 10, the radius of the bottom is 20 centimeters, and the slant height is 26 centimeters. So you substitute the values here. So you have 22 over 7 multiplied by the slant height here, which is 26, then brackets, radius of the larger circle, which is 20, added to the radius of the smaller circle, which is 10. So 20 plus 10 is 30. So you'll have 22 over 7 times 26 times that. When you key in your calculator, you get 24, 51, 3 over 7. On to question 2, reads that the figure below represents a frustum of a solid cone. Base radius is 48 centimeters. The top radius is 16. The height of the frustum, this height here, is 21. So you're asked to find the total surface area of this frustum. It is good to note that it is a solid frustum. So to find the curved surface area of the frustum will be pi L, this one is the slant height, in brackets R plus R. Then because it is a solid, you add the area, the top area, which is pi R squared, plus the bottom area, which is pi R by R squared. So the curved surface area of this frustum, using this formula, we need L. L is the slant height of this frustum. So drop height here, H. This height is the same as that, so this will be 21. So this is a right angle triangle. So we want the length of this size here. So that will be 48 minus 16. 48 minus 16, this will be 32 centimeters. So with 32 centimeters and 21, we can be able to get the hypotenuse, so that this hypotenuse is the slant height of that frustum. So this will be 32 squared added to 21 squared. This will give us L squared. So to get L, that is equals to root of 32 squared added to 21 squared. So our L, using a calculator, will be 38.28 centimeters to 4 significant figures. So substituting all the values in this formula here, we'll have 22 over 7 multiplied by 38.28, the slant height, then in brackets, radius of the larger circle, which is 48, added to the radius of the smaller circle, or the top, which is 16. When you calculate this using your calculator, you'll have 7699.74 centimeters squared. This is the area of the curved surface of that frustum. So we need to add the area of the top. So the area of the top is pi r squared. So that is 22 over 7 times, the radius here is 16. So 16 squared. When you key in your calculator, that is 22 over 7, you get 804 or over 7 centimeters squared. Now, to get the area of the bottom, that will be 22 over 7 times the radius of the bottom is 48 squared. Keying in your calculator, you'll get 41 over 7 centimeters squared. So the total surface area will be the area of the curved surface added to the area of the top, then added to the area of the bottom. So that will be 7241 over 7 added to the area of the top, which is 804 over 7, added to the area of the curved surface, which is this, which is 7699.74. When you add this using your calculator, you'll have 15745.45 centimeters squared. Thank you.